What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you a smooth speed ramp edit in Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create slow motion using any frame rate, how to use time remapping in After Effects, and how to cut a fun dance edit to any beat.
That's good.
Hi, guys. So this tutorial was recommended by Rajiri, my man. He's been asking about speed ramping for, a year, and it's about time that I make a tutorial on it. So let's dive into After Effects, and you guys will notice that I am using a clip from Spider-Man 3 when Tobey Maguire was doing like a weird dance. I just chose it because I thought it would be funny. So, so let me show you what I built, and I will show you how to easily do your own speed ramping, okay? So just check this out real quick.
I love you.
All right, so it's just a short little clip like that. Let's watch it one more time.
I love you.
So I don't know why right here, it was in this clip. There was like a little glitch scene right there. Can't explain it. Sometimes it happens with footage, but it is what it is, okay? So let me show you how to do some speed ramping. On this clip in particular, if we go into the effect controls, you'll see I put a force motion blur. I did a small little wiggle to make this clip look a little more alive. And then I had this text kind of animate on. I have the music right here, so you can see the waveforms. All right, see the audio, there's the waveforms. Okay, and you can also see I put markers on all the beats that I wanted to make cuts to. So if I scroll down, you can see all the clips that I made cuts to. I'll minimize this by selecting all and pressing U. All right, so now we can kind of see things a little better. But yeah, I just kind of cut up the scenes and made them my own, and I enabled time remapping on all of them. So if we go inside of here, and we see the time remap right away. I'm using easy-eased keyframes for my time remapping. Let me just show you guys how I did it. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new composition, clicking the button below, and we're gonna call this speed ramping again. And I got 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second. That's actually the same frames per second as the clip that I'm using, which I would recommend always if you're using footage. And let's hit okay. So this slow motion effect that I'm gonna show you, the speed ramping effect that I'm gonna show you is, it's useful for any frame rate. It doesn't always look incredible, but depending on how you use the effect, it will look incredible. Cause the footage that I was using in this Spider-Man clip, it's all 30 frames per second and it looks really smooth right here. I mean, it's kind of blurry, but I added a motion blur effect to it. Let's build it. All right, so let's add our music in. I'm going to open it up, open up the audio, open up the waveforms. So now I can see what's going on here and I can kind of identify the beats. Okay, you can also change the volume here. I usually go like +5 or this song needs +5. So I'm gonna boost it to 5. And we can see like most of all the beats. Some of them are hi-hats and this is just like a lo-fi soundtrack. So what I would do first is just set markers for all of your beats. Okay, so I'm just gonna listen to the first one here. Okay, so I heard 3 beats, so I'm gonna put a beat here, hitting the star on the number pad, or you can just do an asterisk. Here's a beat, and here's a beat. So I'm gonna finish this out and come back to me once you've done the same. Okay, so I trimmed mine as well. I just trimmed the beginning a little bit. You can see because there's this gap right here. That's because the beats don't start until this point. So I trimmed mine, I'm just gonna put that at the beginning. Now we got our music track with all of the beats on the markers, all right? So next, let's add our footage. So boom, drop our footage in. First thing we do is we right click and we go to time remapping, let's enable it, all right? And you'll notice that there's a keyframe that starts right at the beginning. Let's ignore that for now because those keyframes just represent the points in time within the clip, okay? So what I wanna do is I wanna identify how I want to start this. I think I might start it with Peter just doing one of his dances. So I'm just gonna scroll all the way through here. Maybe like right when he gets on the street. No, I'll do this face. I like this face. So let's, I'm gonna start it right here. So let me add a keyframe here. And I'm also gonna do Command or Control Shift D to make a little cut, okay? Actually, let me add a keyframe on this one. Hold on, time remapping. Okay, so the keyframe is there. And I want it to slow-mo right here on this face. okay? And then I'm gonna do Control Shift D to make a cut there too. And I'm gonna drag this all the way to the beginning. All right, so now we got our clip here. Just chilling, okay? But I wanna turn off the sound to this clip too. Okay, so maybe, you know what? Hold on, I'm gonna remove that I love you part and just have it start right on the beat. Okay, so trim the music. Okay. So let's just do this. Put the clip here, hold shift to have it snap on the playhead. Okay, now I'm going to extend this out to the next bass beat. And I'm actually gonna move this keyframe as well because this is the exact frame that I want it to end on. So when I move it, it's actually just going to create a slow-mo. But the slow-mo won't look as good as we need it to, you'll see. So it's kind of choppy, right? You see that? It's a little choppy, just a little bit. So in order to get rid of that, we just need to turn on this one thing called frame blending. Okay, so it's this little icon right here. Frame blending interpolates frame content by weighted blending, blah, blah, blah. All right, and then let's click once on it and click again, because this turns on the optical flow setting of frame blending. So we also want to make sure that this frame blending toggle is on, make sure that's blue. Sometimes it's not. And now if we play it, and look at that, it looks so smooth. It's like real smooth slow-mo. It's because it's a little blurry. Now, if you think it's a little too blurry, what you can do is you can actually add a sharpen effect. So I'm gonna add a sharpen effect. And let's just drop it on and maybe we'll bring it, I don't know, whatever looks best. How about like, do like 80. I guess that's fine. Maybe it's a little too sharp. I'll bring it down to like 44. Okay, so it's sharpened, it looks nice, and it's slow-mo, but we want it to do a speed ramp, okay? A speed ramp is from fast to slow. So in order to do that, I'm just gonna highlight both of these keyframes. I'm gonna right-click them, go to Keyframe Assistant, click on Easy Ease, okay? So now let's see what it looks like. All right, hold on, it was a little laggy. So it had a little bit of a speed ramp there, actually. Let's make it a little more specific by clicking on the keyframe. Now we want to make sure it's clicked, and then click on the graph editor right here. Okay, so inside the graph editor, you'll see there's the handles here off of the yellow keyframes, all right? And I wanna make sure that I'm looking at the value graph, not the speed graph. The speed graph is useful, but the value graph is more useful for this specific effect, okay? So the value graph is awesome because what you can do is you can kind of read it pretty easily. So this shows the rate of speed that it goes, okay? So it starts off slow. So slow means flat. Fast means more angled. So during this ramp, that's the speed, okay? So it's going really fast, that's velocity. And then as it evens out, it slows down, okay? So this even line is slow. So I want it to be slow, even slower towards the end, okay? So I'm gonna drag this handle out. And look, it's getting flatter and flatter. But this is actually going up, so that means there's gonna be some more speed. So in order to remove a lot of speed, I'm gonna do this and kind of even out that speed, and it really slows down like that. Okay, so let's see what this looks like now. See, that's what really slowed down. I love his face, man. Okay, so there's a nice speed ramp. Now let's do another clip, okay? So I'm gonna do three more clips. You guys should get the gist. But yeah, so I'm just gonna copy paste this, and let's just drag this over here. And I'm going to delete these keyframes and let's just kind of pick another moment in time. Okay, so I just kind of pull it out and let's do maybe one of the snaps. Does he have a snap coming up? Yeah. Okay, it's blurry as I scrub, but it's fine. Okay, so I'm gonna do one of these snaps. All right, so I'm going to trim this, add a keyframe for the time remap. And right where I want it to slow-mo is like right after the snap, okay? So let's do another keyframe and let's easy ease these. Keyframe assistant, easy ease. Pull this to the next clip. And oh, okay, so see how my beat is right here? I actually need it to go a little faster. So I'm gonna bring this in and trim this clip. But it's still the same time, it's just faster now. But I easy eased it, so you'll see that it's got a little bit of speed ramp to it. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same effect. I'm gonna go make sure I click on that keyframe, go to the graph editor, and let's hold Alt and scroll with our mouse wheel to zoom in here. And I can pull this to the left and maybe even that out like that. Okay, so let's see how that looks. Let's go to the beginning. Okay, so it's pretty fast right there, but that's because I chose a lot of time to pass here. So maybe what I can do is I can actually add a keyframe here, delete that one, pull this back, and now, ooh. But that doesn't really include the snap. So I'm gonna undo that real quick. I want the snap like right here. Okay, so this will include the snap. Delete this keyframe, pull it to the beginning. Oh yeah, look at that, look at that. Bam. He's snapping, man. Oh my gosh, I want to finish this out and post it for you guys because I just think it's hilarious. Okay, so let's do one more clip. I'm gonna copy this, paste it, drag it down to the next beat, and let's unminimize this, and let's delete these two keyframes, find our next clip. Okay, so let's see. Ah, it's so perfect. Okay, so I'm just gonna delete this. I'm going to add a keyframe here for the time remap. Oh yeah, let's stop it here. Ah, oh, this is just literally the perfect music and the perfect video, perfect scene. Okay. And let's go ahead and ease these in. Oops. Ease in. Oh no, not ease in. Just straight up easy ease. And there's also a hotkey for that, so I'm just gonna hit F9. There we go. Oops. F9. And then let's click on the keyframe, hit the speed graph, zoom in a little bit, pull this one out, and even this one. All right, and let's see how this looks. Come on, baby. It's so good. Does it freeze there? Yeah, it does. Okay, it froze like that because I think I went up on here. So if I zoom in here, you'll see maybe it's not a perfect, I'll bring it down a little bit and then maybe it won't freeze. Let's see. Oh, it's close. It does freeze. Okay, so I can keep it from freezing by just bringing this influence down. All right, so let's see how this looks. So yeah, we could just keep playing around with this and just keep speed ramping to our heart's desire and keep tweaking everything, removing all the pieces we don't like, the pieces we do like. So let me show you a brightness effect to add to each scene to level it up. So let's go to brightness and contrast. Let's just drag it on this clip. And I'm going to keyframe the brightness and contrast and maybe bring it all the way up, maybe like that. And with these keyframes, hold on, let me press U here. So the keyframes are all the way at the bottom. I don't know if you guys can see this. Okay, I'm gonna go to the right and I'm going to set them to 0. Okay, so they just kind of go and I'm gonna ease in the last keyframe. And now I'm gonna click on brightness and contrast and just paste it on all of the other clips. So every time a new clip comes on, it gets bright and fades off. It's just, I can't get over his face. Okay. And then if you wanna add some motion blur too, it's a little subtle, you just type in force motion blur, and we're actually going to apply this to a adjustment layer. We're just gonna drop it on, kind of makes things load a lot slower, so make sure your computer can handle it. So let's render this. Okay, so let's see if it added anything. Maybe a little bit, makes it look a little smoother. I think I like it. So yeah, it's a little subtle thing. It might add that much more to your finished edit. Just add that forced motion blur. And what it does is it kind of, the screen senses any movement and it adds motion blur to that movement. So it's pretty cool. It's a real fast way to add motion blur to anything. All right, guys, so I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial. I had a lot of fun making it, as you could tell. And before I go, I want to leave you guys with the next video that I want you to watch, which is my animated subscribe button tutorial. It's a free motion graphics template you can apply to any of your videos. So if you make one of these speed ramping videos, go ahead and apply the subscribe button to it, and you'll be golden. So I will see you guys in there. Yeah.